In this video, we are going to talk about parent-child relationship in SQL using foreign keys. We are going to create the two tables. We will discuss the syntax of both the tables and the foreign key. We are also going to talk about the advantages foreign key offers, the challenges we may have with primary key and foreign key relationships, and how they are usually tackled in real projects. So let's get started. So foreign keys, which are basically used to link two tables, ensures that child cannot have a record which is not present in the parent. For example, you cannot sell a product which is not present on your shelf or inventory. Usually in our database or OLAP system, dimension tables are the parent table and the fact table are the child tables. Let's create both of them and see their syntax here. So here I am creating this product parent demo table, which has these four columns: product ID, product name, manufacturer and price. Notice I have not created any primary key, index or constraint on this table just yet. Let's insert 100 row into this table using our SQL query. The rows have been inserted. Now this table contains the list of 100 products that the organization is offering, who is manufacturing those products, and what should be the selling price. Now these products will be sold to the customers, and those entries will come in our order table. The order table has four columns: order ID, product ID, order date, and the quantity of products sold in that transaction. Notice here also I have not created any foreign key constraints just yet. If we try to insert a row into this table with the product ID 101, ideally that should not be allowed, for the simple reason because this product is not part of our product table. How can we sell something that we do not have? Well, it still allowed this data to be inserted in our order table, breaking the integrity of our application. Now we are claiming that we have sold something that we don't even have. In order to avoid this scenario from happening, we create the foreign key constraint so that every time we insert something in our child table, it only allows us to be inserted if that value exists in the parent table as well. Let's drop this table and recreate it with foreign key constraints. For that, after the last column, we can add a comma and write the keyword foreign key, and then in brackets we have to write the column on which we are going to create our foreign key, or the column which will be used in our join condition. Then we will specify the keyword references, and finally the name of our parent table and the column in brackets which will be referred in our parent table, or the column from parent table which we are going to use in our join condition. Let's try to run this. We get an error which states that the parent table column which is getting referenced does not have a unique or primary key constraint. So guys, remember, the column from our parent table that we are going to reference in our child table must have a unique or primary key constraint. Let's drop the parent table and we are going to create it again, but this time we will make the product ID primary key of the table. Let's also insert the data again into this new table. And now let's create our child table again with the foreign key constraint, and this time it allowed us to create that. Now if we try to insert 101 product ID, it is giving us an error stating that referential integrity constraint violated. This does not exist in parent, hence we cannot insert it in child. Before we move ahead and discuss further things, let's do a quick recap. We create foreign key constraints on child table to ensure referential integrity, which in simple terms mean that something which does not exist in the parent table cannot be a part of the child table as well. The columns from parent table which will be referred by the child table must have a unique or primary key constraint on them, otherwise the child table will not be able to have the foreign key constraint. To create the foreign key, we use the keyword references, and anything that does not exist in the parent table, if we try to insert that value in the child table, it will give us an error. Now that we understand why we create foreign keys, let's understand a couple of their disadvantages. While doing inserts in our child table or fact table, it will have to check every time if the value exists in parent or not. And this can reduce the performance of our inserts. Even though the parent table reference column is indexed, if the table size is huge, it can lead to slight performance issues if we are doing huge amount of inserts in our child table regularly. Now, how do we tackle such situations? Well, if we are confident that our child table will not get any record that can violate the referential integrity, we can disable the index prior to loading and then we can enable them back after the load. In most cases, when your parent dimension tables and corresponding indexes are not huge in size, you will not notice any significant delay in inserts even if the foreign key constraints are not disabled. Another problem can happen if you decide to delete a record from the parent dimension table. For example, if we try to delete product 1 from the product table because we are not planning to sell it in future, it will give us an error stating that this record exists in the child table and cannot be deleted. If deleted, it will lead to referential integrity violations. Now, at the time of defining our child table, we have options which allows us to delete the data from the child table as well. In case our application allows to delete records from the parent, we can use onDelete cascade, which essentially means if a record is deleted from the parent table, all its corresponding records from the child table will be deleted as well. Or we can also use onDeleteSetNull, which means if the record is deleted from the parent, all the corresponding child records values will be set to null. Let's see this in action with these two tables. Both of them have the exact same structure and they both have a foreign key constraint on the product demo table. The first one uses onDelete cascade while the second one uses onDeleteSetNull. I'm going to insert 100 rows to both of these tables with product ID between 1 and 20. And now I'm going to confirm whether product ID 5 exists in both table, and I'm also going to check if there are any null values. Let's confirm that. Yes, we have the product ID 5 in both tables, and also there are no null values in either of the tables. Now when we delete the product ID 5 from the parent product table, all records with the product ID 5 will be deleted from the first child table as well. While for the second table, wherever we had product ID 5, it will be replaced with null. Let's verify this as well. And we can see our code is working as expected. Now, does it really happen in real projects that you delete something from your parent table which exists in your child table? In a well-designed project, this almost never happens. Instead of physically deleting the record from the parent table, we perform something called soft delete, which means we will have a column in our table indicating if the record is active or not. If we do not plan to sell the product anymore, instead of deleting the record, we will simply change the value of our indicator to inactive. For example, if we consider the employee table, all employees that are currently working in the organization will be considered active or will have Y as flag, and people who have left the organization will be inactive or will have N as flag. It's not that we are going to delete their information from the employee table altogether. But if we ever have a situation or scenario where we have to delete some records from the parent table, the delete process is written in a way that the corresponding child table records are deleted first and then the parent's records are deleted, so that we have clear control on what is getting deleted from our tables. If we have delete on cascade enabled, and by mistake, if somebody deletes everything from the parent table, we will lose everything from the child as well. So in a well-designed application, you will mostly see soft delete, or if hard deletes are recorded, then child data will be deleted in a controlled manner prior to deleting the parent data. Also, if our applications allows parent data to be deleted, it is advisable that we create an index on the foreign key columns in our child table. If we do not create the index, it will lead to full table scans, even for a single row deletion, which can lead to table locking issues. I believe we have discussed a lot already. Before moving forward, let's do a quick recap of the key points related to foreign keys. While inserting data into the child table, Oracle checks if the foreign key column value exists in the parent table or not. This can lead to slight performance issues if the table and index sizes are huge and we insert large amount of data frequently in our child table. The data from parent table cannot be deleted if we have corresponding records existing in our child table. While creating the foreign key, we have the option to delete records from child as well using delete cascade or by setting the values as null. But in most real projects, instead of actually deleting the parent record, we just inactivate it. Also, if our application allows deletion from the parent table, then we should create index on the foreign key column in our child table to avoid table locking issues. One other scenario that happens often in real projects is associated to late arriving dimensions or early arriving fact. Actually, in real projects, the parent data or dimension data and the child data or fact data, they come from different systems. Occasionally, it does happen that we get a value in our child foreign key column which is not yet available in the parent dimension table. This simply happens because the system which is sending us the parent or dimension data had a failure of some sorts. Now, in such situations, what should we do? If we try to insert the fact or child data, it will give us an error that the data is not present in the parent table. Well, there are multiple ways to handle such situations. Either we can park such records into a different table and we can process them at a later stage once we get the parent data next day, or we can assign a dummy value in the child foreign key column for such cases, or there are some other ways as well. If you are interested in learning more about late arriving dimensions, you can watch the next video on the same. I hope this video clarifies all your doubts in relation to foreign key. Let's do a quick recap. The parent table column, which will be referred or which will be used in the join, should have a unique or primary key constraint. The child table references the parent table and can only contain values that are present in the parent. The foreign key column will be used to join these two tables. If our system allows to delete records from the parent table, then we should create an index on the foreign key columns in the child table to avoid table locking issues. Foreign keys, as we discussed earlier, can reduce the insert performance in specific cases. In most cases, in real-world applications, instead of doing hard deletes, we perform a soft delete using inactivation of records in our parent or dimension table. And we have certain cases of late arriving dimensions where we receive dimensions after the fact data. If you want to learn more about this specific scenario, you can watch the next video. Guys, I hope this video was helpful. In case if you still have any doubt, please post it in the comment section and I'll be happy to help.